Yeah.
It was smash and grab. Without the grab.
The very expensive showdown between the richest man in the world and one of the most popular social media platforms.
Okay, so Elon Musk has called off his deal with Twitter.
He announced on Friday that he now wants out.
Twitter is now suing Musk in an attempt to close a takeover deal.
Now, you might ask yourself,
well, how did I get here?
Like most epic tales, it started with a Twitter poll.
Free speech is essential to functioning democracy. Do you believe Twitter rigorously adheres to this principle? The consequences of this poll will be important. Please vote carefully.
On April 4, Musk revealed he'd secretly built up a 9% stake in the social media giant, making him its largest shareholder.
Oh, hi. LOL.
Then on April 14, he offered to buy the whole company for roughly $44 billion. Along the way, he pledged to make Twitter great again with beefed up free speech protections, an edit button, and an unbanned Donald Trump running amok. Yay. But things got messy.
He was offered and then ended up not taking a position on the company's board, instead launching a takeover bid for Twitter. Tech stocks across the world started to slide in value, and the morale of people working at Twitter was slipping.
And on May 13, it got worse.
One of the richest people on the planet says that he's changed his mind about buying Twitter.
So what was the problem? Basically, the platform had too many spam bots and not enough real, unique humans.
The number of real, unique humans that you see making comments on a daily basis on Twitter is above 95%. That is what they're claiming.
So you see, that's where the trouble began. That smile. That damn smile.
Tesla CEO Elon Musk says that fake accounts could amount to a fifth of Twitter's users. That's four times more than he was initially told.
When Twitter initially refused Musk's demand to see detailed user data, he caught a gnarly case of buyer's remorse.
My God, what have I done?
And last Friday, he pulled the pin on the whole deal.
Oh, geez, I think I paid too much trying to walk away. That happens quite a bit.
I think it was a shock to Twitter, and now they sharpen their knives going to the Delaware court.
And if Musk is wondering,
am I right? Am I wrong?
To back out of the buyout, experts reckon you're wrong, Elon.
These contracts are drafted to provide a high degree of certainty for the sellers.
Unless there's some sort of out-and-out fraud, which no one has found, my understanding. No fraud found. He owns it.
While his tendency to taunt the Twitterati might delight his musketeers, it probably breaches the terms of the takeover contract.
He has been negotiating in total bad faith. He has disrupted the company. He has been disparaging them. He has destroyed shareholder value, all in the attempt to try and get out of the deal that they want him to try and buy.
Even Donald Trump turned on him.
Elon, he's another bullshit artist.
The whole saga sent Twitter shares down the slippery dip. But here's the freaky bit. That might have been Musk's fiendish plan all along. The recent market downturn has hammered tech stocks like Tesla. So some suspect Musk's actually trying to tank Twitter to make his margins meet.
Now this has to be the mother of all cons.
My suspicion is that it's really just a simple thing. Elon Musk has to stump up billions of dollars for a company that is worth less than half what it was when he initially made the offer.
But if the case against Musk sticks, Twitter's gambit could net a $1 billion penalty payment, a band-aid over the hefty reputational damage and impending market massacre. Or courts could force through the hostile takeover Twitter never wanted, possibly revealing the true number of bots on the platform.
Just to be clear, everyone's a loser in terms of how this ultimately played out.
I mean, nothing warms the heart more than a rich is the richest story. But the most, all the business stuff aside, that'll work itself out. But the most fascinating stuff for me is I want to find out how many bots are on Twitter. Don't we all want to find that out?
Right. Yeah.
We all think, we live in this world where you think everyone's on Twitter. Mm-hmm. And that's not true anyway, including the bots. But if you include the bots, like, you know, one-fifth of the people on Twitter might not be able to tell where the traffic lights are in those squares. I want to know. I want to know that. That's the most fascinating thing about this. I think Elon Musk is within his rights to ask that. Twitter is about people. He should know how many actual people are on Twitter as opposed to bots.
It would definitely be good to know. I mean, he probably should have asked that before he offered to buy it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
I just want to say, has there ever been a billionaire who could dance? No, seriously, we've seen Bill Gates, he sucks. Elon Musk, that was crap.
Kim Kardashian?
Yeah, probably.
She could dance.